Hello everyone, this is Mr. Albert Ronan here again, and today I'm here for my breakdown on Gran Torino. And oh my god. I know everyone's fought against a Gran Torino online that's just button mashing, pressing all of his dash moves, like moving around like a maniac. But oh my goodness, I did not realize how broken Gran Torino was until I took him into training mode. Do you know of many characters that can get 11,000 damage without a dash cancel, just off of a regular combo? It's pretty easy to execute. There we go, 11,000 damage, didn't even cost me a dash cancel. Super easy damage for Gran Torino. Or I can even make it even more if I add in a single dash cancel. Wait, that's not it, 13,000 damage, but I can make it even better with only one dash cancel. Oh, damn it, wait. I feel like it's important to show you this at the very start, just so you know what we're working with. And yes, this is all a real combo, the opponent's on recovery, and I just did 16,000 damage with a single dash cancel off of a regular hit. So if I punish someone, and all of a sudden I'm doing 16,000 damage, over half of their life. Oh god, not to mention he has other really awesome, crazy, overpowered buttons. But, okay, let's just get into his buttons. So his regular attack string is this four-hitting attack string that actually leaves him in the air. And because he's in the air, he can link it into his air armor attack, and then his air armor attack can be cancelled into other easy quirk buttons, which is where the crazy combos start. Even that super basic combo was 18,700 damage. His air attack string is a three-input attack string that ends in a multi-hit at the end. It is really good, and you're in the air, so you can do the same thing as you did before. You can cancel into his yellow attack, which can be cancelled into other buttons. And yeah, all of his buttons have pretty decent startup speed. His ground one is a bit slower, but a lot of the time you're in the air with Gran Torino. I'm sure you've experienced this if you're online. If you decide to jump, Gran Torino's in the air and attacking you instantly, because his air attack is really fast. Maybe even faster, like including the jump, it's faster than his ground attack, so it's really fast. Okay, his red attack. Now we're already getting to the overpowered things. Let me show you. You don't think I'm gonna start my red attack from over here, do you? Well, yes. It is this ridiculous roll that just travels infinitely until it hits the opponent. And unlike combo, you know, like 100% Deku's red attack that people complain about because it like reaches like for so long and it's crazy. Well, this one you can actually combo off of. So it's just like a normal red attack, except it is like full screen for some reason. Why is this a thing? Obviously it's reactable, but a lot of the time the opponent tries to like sidestep or dash out of the way, but this thing like tracks as well, so it's gonna... Look at this! My Bakugo is dashing around, and this hits him. That's ridiculous. That's crazy. Look, and it just follows him till the ends of the earth, until he decides just die to get hit. And then, oh, you got hit? Well, if you don't have supports, look, I'm gonna just quickly hit you with my 16,000 damage combo if you don't stop and you're not Mr. Albert Ronan while he's recording. Like, oh, I didn't even do an optimal damage combo, but you were dashing around and you were trying to avoid my red attack? Oh, well, you just took like 14,000 damage because I used a single dash cancel. Fine, easy. Oh, this is just where the dirt's starting, guys. Oh my god. So, yeah, crazy red attack. Obviously, it's very good for using in unblockable setups or whatever. But also, its main use is it's just so crazy tracking. See, when Bakugo was dashing or running around, usually a red attack whiffs then. The only way to avoid it is if you sidestep right before it hits you in the face. But oh my god, it's crazy. Okay, and yeah, as you saw, you combo out of it. No. The only bad thing about Gran Torino is this ground yellow attack isn't that great. It's really not that great. It's the only bad thing about him, so you can't complain. He can't really combo into anything for free without it. He can combo into it, I think if he does two hits, You can combo into it, but the only way you're going to get anything off of it is if you dash cancel. Which, to be honest, is fine, because if... because you're getting huge damage no matter how many dash cancels you use. So yeah, it gets the job done as a yellow attack, like if your opponent's pressing buttons or trying to get out of what you're doing. If they know that there's a gap in between your second and third hit, or third or fourth hit, you can throw it in to try and interrupt them, trying to interrupt you. Then, and yeah, and you hit them, you do a dash cancel. And you're just doing huge damage, even if you mess up there, I still got 11,000 damage. His air yellow attack is good because you can combo into it and out of it and get super easy damage. And essentially it's just like, it's just adding damage to your combos, like even meterlessly. So if you do your regular attack string that leaves you in the air into this, into his quirk 1, you can jump into the air, and then do follow-up attacks, and yeah, it's ridiculous. Okay, now, let's get into his quirk 1. So, if you just tap quirk 1, he does this weird little, like, zip, like, stomp, he, like, jumps in the air and then jumps back down. You can actually angle it, so you can choose the direction that he goes in, and this will hit the opponent if you do it at the right place. And it also hits them if you land back on them. And if your opponent decides to come near you when you try and do this, it can work as a dodge, and then if you hit them with the down thing, you're going in for a full combo again. And that wasn't optimal at all, still got 13,000 damage. Can you see where the ridiculous is? Like, so, yeah. And not only is this move... so, there's so much to cover even just in this one button. So it can be really good as a counter, like if you're near the opponent and you do this, you jump up above them, and you hit them with this, and then you get to go in for a full combo, if it hits them like that. It can also be used as like a fake out in a guard string, so it looks like you're gonna go in for something, and you've gone to run away, but then he like teleports back to the original spot, and then you can attack. Oops. It looks like you're retreating, and then you can attack instantly, and it leads to his weird guard pressure. You can dash into the opponent, and then have the hits hit him, because then he hits them, and then you're doing an air combo suddenly, and then you're doing... and you can see how his like block pressure is kind of ridiculous, because it's just so hard to see what he's doing, because all of his moves kind of look the same. Like, he has buttons, and then like zip moves, you can't really tell what he's doing. Yeah, so with this button also, if you press it again, instead of going back to the original position, so if I go like this, he'll go back to the original position. If you press the button again, he will do a kick that goes towards the opponent. And even if you do it on the spot, he'll just jump into the air and do a kick that goes towards the opponent. Which is good in block pressure, obviously, because even though he isn't truly plus after that, like, the opponent can attack before you, but I believe it is safe. You can, like, attack after it usually, because your opponent doesn't know where it's gonna end. And if they do think they can, they have the audacity of trying to interrupt you as Gran Torino, and you've done this, like, you can do a dash cancel, I believe. Or cancel it into something else. It's just, it's really ridiculous. And so you can do the retreat and then actually do a launch at them instead of launching to original position. It looks like you're running away and now you're attacking them, and then you're still attacking them because they can't tell when your block string is over. Yeah. In the air, it works practically the same, except if you tap it once, he's always going to go towards the opponent. You can choose to go backwards or whatever direction, but the neutral one is a quick little zip towards the opponent. And you can press it twice, and he will do both of them. And this can be good for adding some damage to your air combos. So that simple combo still did a lot of damage. And in the air, as you saw with the huge combos I was doing before, you can cancel it. Oh, sorry. You cancel it after his armor attack and do a single hit of the quirk 1. And jump into the air. And that's a proper extension. That's a true combo there. Like, the opponent can't recover or do anything. That's a real combo. And it's 11,000 damage, completely meterless. Yeah. And I'm not even done talking about this move, guys. So if you're, like, trying to get in, you're on your opponent. Because you can, it has directional control. You can control which direction you're going in. So if you're trying to get around projectiles, you can go, like, you know, try and get... go in weird angles to try and dodge the projectile, but then also go in on the opponent. So if I like go around the projectile and back in, not only like would that on its own be good against projectiles, but if I hold the button down, he is a charged version, which has armor on both hits. So he has armor on this part and on the second part. So he's yellow. He has armor for that for like so long. It's a full second of armor, I believe, where he is doing these ridiculous dashes. Just on top of the opponent, and you can always have this charged up, and obviously it leads to combos as well, because why would something with Gran Torino not lead to combos? A single dash cancel, you know, 13,000 damage, because you got hit by a yellow attack, so what? But you can always have this charged up, because in this, I can be holding down the button, and see now, I have the charged version, because I was holding the button down while I'm in the animation of this. It's ridiculous. So yeah, he will. If you're playing him correctly, you'll always have the charged version. And the charged version is just basically better. It's more plus on hit. It's a little bit slower, and it all has armor, so if your opponent tries to interrupt whatever you're doing, because sometimes with the regular one, the opponent can just attack you, and like interrupts whatever you're trying to do. But obviously, if it's this version, they can't interrupt you because it has armor now. It's so ridiculous, like, I just can't believe this is actually in the game. And obviously, I said the other one was really good for avoiding zoning, but this one is like really, really good for avoiding zoning, because if I'm like over here, I can just do like two charges in, and you know, the second one didn't even have armor for some reason. And yeah, you've just like armored your way through projectiles and launched yourself at the opponent. It's so good. And also, a lot of the time, if your opponent's going to try and interrupt a gap in your block string, or if you're, like, doing attacks and you've whiffed or something, cancel into his, just standing version, where he jumps up and down, because he has armor for the whole animation. And if the opponent even comes near you, if they get hit by the up jump or the down, like, smash, you get a full combo off of it, just because they've decided to either come close to you or try and hit you. And even if they try and do a red attack to interrupt it, it's gonna like dodge it. So if you do this and they come near you at all, you're practically guaranteed to get a combo afterwards, which we all know already is a death sentence if you're against Gran Torino. Even if you mess it up, I got like 10,000 damage plus that 4,000 damage that didn't even connect. Okay, I think we're done talking about his quirk one. Obviously he doesn't have a tilt quirk one because has a directional quirk one. He can choose what direction to go in. Okay. Whew. Now for his quirk 2. Wait, just another thing about... just the guard pressure is so ridiculous. So if you do two hits into this, it does a lot of the guard pressure, and you're in the air now if you do an attack off. So if I do two hits into his quirk 1, and if I just do the regular version where he stomps up and down, not only does it take a lot of their gut, like their stamina meter, but you're also, like, almost plus on block. It's probably zero, so you can both attack at the same time. So your opponent can try and mash and get a yellow attack out or something. But it's super unsafe, seeing as your air attack is really fast. So characters with a slow attack, like Endeavor or something, there's just genuinely nothing they can do except an armor attack to try and squeeze through here. And you've just, like, completely destroyed them and broken their guard. And you can go in for your freaking 16,000 damage combo now. Yeah, and, like, you can even use it. Whoa. Lag. And yeah, so if I do my two hits into this, instead of doing that, which I'm sure they're already scared of, you can do two hits, and that even just, like, what? That hit, I tried to do a retreat there, but even the retreat hits the opponent as you run away. So, like, if you decide you don't want to be nearby, you hit the opponent and run away at the same time. It's ridiculous. He is crazy block pressure with this. You can basically just do like a few hits into any version of this. You can do the tilt version of this. You can do the regular version where he just stomps back to the original because it like resets where you were. You can just do two hits into the normal one, because they're not going to expect where you're going. Or you can stomp back down, and then you get a combo off of it if they try and press a button. It's so crazy. You can use it as a retreat, because it has directional input. It's crazy, guys. I'm sorry for ranting about this for so long, but it's ridiculous. Okay, his quirk 2 is this charge that is also ridiculous. It doesn't seem like it does that much damage, but trust me, it does so much damage when you add it into his combos. Because for some reason, unlike other attacks in this game, it doesn't really scale at all. So like, the 4000 damage that it does, even after a long combo, like, I've done a bunch of hits into things, and usually your combo scales near the end. Attacks don't do the same amount of damage that they do throughout the whole thing, or else you'll have infinite combos. But for some reason, this move, for some reason, like, doesn't scale at all. So you can, and you can dash cancel after. So you can do combos like this. That's 3 dash cancels, 4 dash cancels, and you've done like 13,000 damage for this super easy stuff. Usually characters have to do like 5 or 6 dash cancels in order to get that much damage, or use a plus ultra. But for some reason, Gran Torino can just, you know, do normal combos like this. Oh, I even messed it up. Sorry. So, oh my god. Hello? What is happening? So you're always going to be going into this, and then dash cancelling out of it if you want, and then going into it again, and that was just like one repetition, and that would have been 14,000 damage. Oh no, that combo there is 16,000 damage, but yet, like, if he wants, he can just do this all day, and obviously he can charge up his, this, I charged that up while I was in it, so it's really good for that as well, so you can always go into that. Because when you're in the air, by the way, if you're high in the air, and I've, like, you go into your armor attack, if you go into this, you can get another extension, if, like, the charged version of his quirk 1. If I'm high in the air, which I probably am after my long combos, I have some more meter back. Oops, what am I doing? But essentially, he can combo off of his stuff even more. And I'm not showing it very well there. Here, let me show you it in the combo. I showed it at the beginning of the video, but I'll show it again. So while he's in this animation, I'm holding down the button, and oops, I even forgot to dash cancel. My bad. Into this, and then you can jump into the air and get follow-ups again. I was a bit slow there, but then I showed it at the beginning of the video already, and you get 16,000 damage for a single dash cancel. So this move is not only really good because he gets huge damage off of it, and you can, like, repeat it infinitely because none of the hits in the air or this, like, before you dash cancel, if you dash cancel it, there's nothing here that meaty blows. So he can do this, like, till you're dead. It's ridiculous. So, like, if you're ever low on health, and Gran Torino has meter, you bet your ass that he's going to be doing this until you're dead. Just constantly going into this, dash cancelling, until you're dead, because there's no risk. Like, he can just, there's no possibility that you're gonna meteor blow, so he can just keep doing huge damage. Literally infinitely until you're dead. And that didn't even meteor blow, guys. Did you see that? The final hit. If I was facing it, oh my god. If he was facing a wall then, that would have been a wall splat after that huge combo. Can you believe that? That wasn't a meteor blow. Oh my god. It's so awful. It's so dirty. I hate it so much. So even after I did that 21,000, like, infinite combo that lasted for like 2 minutes, it wasn't even a meaty blow. So yeah, essentially this move, you're always going to end your combos in it, and extend your combos with it, because it does a lot of damage. Okay, I think we can stop talking about that. Now, here's a move that you probably haven't seen me use yet, because I don't use it in combos, but it is equally as overpowered as all of his other quirk buttons. So I will put Bakugo onto doing his version of projectile. And okay, maybe this is a bad example, because he's a really large hitting projectile. Okay, let me... Wait, does he have... Charged Quark Special 2? No. But essentially, against like 90% of the projectiles in this game, this is immune to the projectiles, because when he's in the dash state, he is invincible against projectiles. And so basically he can just do this and run in on the opponent, and it hits them like literally every time. Like even against the like top players that I've fought against, ones that are like, oh, I'm the number one Gran Torino or Momo or whatever, they don't know how to deal with this. Like, the projectiles don't work against it, he's immune to projectiles, it just tracks down the opponent until you get to the opponent. You can cancel it early by pressing B again. I mean, doing the Tilt Quirk 2 input again. Then he stops, like, and cancels to the floor. And it's actually completely safe. Like, you can see after he cancels it, he can block instantly. So it's completely safe cancel. There's no risk of you being, hit. But also, what's crazy about this is, like, a lot of the time, the opponent can't punish you by doing, like, literally anything. So, you know, I go in on them, and then they're like, oh, I'll block it. Like, the opponent did just then. But, you know what's crazy about this move? Is it's safe on block. This move here, if I get the opponent to block and do a target combo, I believe, hopefully I'm not proven wrong here, but... Or at least every time I've done it online, it's completely safe and the opponent hasn't punished me. Okay, so apparently it isn't... Oh no, there we go. Yeah, it's completely safe. You just have to do like a sidestep or something if you want it, because you can't block when you're in the air. So I could do a just guard if I wanted to, but a lot of times it's easiest just to do a dodge. And then if they try to punish you for doing this move, because, like, obviously it's punishable, or that's what your opponent would expect, because it's this, like, full-screen reaching, projectile-avoiding, like, dashing move. Obviously it has to be unsafe. Like, that's what you'd expect, because he's gonna hit you and you're gonna be unsafe. But, nope. They try and punish you. Instead, you punish them for trying to punish you. Because that's fair. Imagine trying to punish Gran Torino, lol. You just took 11,000 damage combo from an unoptimal. But yeah, this move is crazy ridiculous. Even a lot of the time the opponent can't even like punish it if I'm just blocking, because it recovers so quickly. So, oh wait, I have him still on guard. Oops. Because I recover so quickly, and like a lot of the time I can attack before they can. So let me test that, actually quickly. So I put the opponent onto action after guarding, and target combo. This might not work because this is a bot, so they're going to be mashing as soon as they can possible, but yeah, okay, so that doesn't work. But online, usually I can just mash buttons afterwards, and it interrupts whatever the opponent tries to do, because they have to react on frame 1 of this, because it's only slightly unsafe. So a lot of the time, I hit them with it, and I'm still mashing buttons, and then they've gotten hit, and then they're in a full combo, and then... They're very sad, okay? Because it's so mean. Like, are you seeing this? Just because they tried to, like, punish me for doing this, like, move that is very... looks like it should be punishable. It gets in on your opponent, it tracks him down to literally like hell, unless they somehow avoid it for like 5 seconds, as you saw before. But a lot of the time they're gonna block it, but you're actually safe. Like, you can just sidestep or do literally anything. Like, usually even an attack, and it's gonna interrupt your opponent. So it's just like, if your opponent's trying to zone you out, not only do you have this amazing, like, charge-in yellow attack, you can also just do this, like, it gets, like, it's a get-out-of-jail-free card against zoners, because it just, like, instantly brings you in. If they block it, then you go for your pressure, and then with all this stuff... Oh. It's so crazy, guys. It's so crazy. Okay. Oh, oops, didn't mean to take off recovery. But yeah, that's all of his buttons covered. Oh my goodness, finally. Actually, I haven't even showed his Plus Ultra 1. Which, for any other character, literally any other character in this game, this would be crazy overpowered. It does high damage, it does maybe above average damage for plus ultra ones. Usually they do 7,000 damage, unless they're like special like Momo or regular Deku. But you saw there, the opponent is stuck in the floor, like in a wall splat state. So we can get a combo off of this. Come on, what the hell? Why can't other characters have this? Literally any other character in this game, if they had this, it would make them overpowered. Look at this combo I just did, guys. That was zero dash cancels, just using the plus ultra. The thing is, with Gran Torino, it's not really that helpful for him, because he can get that much damage, like, with one dash cancel. So he can't really appreciate... Oh, that wasn't an optimal combo. But the combo I showed at the beginning, where he goes into the charge stuff, into the stuff... I'll show it later in the combo segment. But he can get 16,000 damage for a single dash cancel. So, there's not really a point in him having a plus ultra that can lead into a combo that, like, you can get that much damage. Because you're just wasting your meter. Obviously, it's very good, like... Because it's unblockable, I think it's unbreakable, so their supports aren't going to be able to get, like, interrupt it. So if you're trying to do something, if they think they're going to call out support, you can go into this, and then you've got a guaranteed chunk of damage. But, yeah, I usually never find myself using this, even though it's such an amazing tool. If any other character in the game, this would be so crazy and overpowered, having it plus ultra that does really good damage, and you can combo out of it. What? And like, obviously he can go into his red attack. Okay, wait, let me show you what a combo with this looks like. So if I go... damage off of a single plus ultra combo, no dash cancels or anything. Like, with any other character, that would be ridiculously overpowered, but Gran Torino can't appreciate it because he can get that much damage with a single dash cancel. Like, oh. Okay, now we can get into his combos, and I think... I mean, I've basically spoiled everything. I've shown it all already. But basically, his bread and butter that you're going to be trying to aim for... Actually, let's show... that you can get tons of damage completely meterlessly. So if you get your punish, you know, you don't want to spend your meter, you're trying to save up for some reason. 11,000 damage. Zero dash cancels. Completely free. Okay. And if you want to use a single dash cancel, well then, you can go 4 hits into armor move, quirk 1, jump in the air, and charge your quirk 1 while you're in this. Armor attack, quirk 1, jump in the air. Oh, I was a bit slow, damn it. Oh, so close to getting a first try. Oh, damn it, you have to time that a little bit as well. Wait, come on, I can do this. I need to show you. It's not crazy hard, I just am very good at messing up combos when I'm recording. No! Oh my god! Here we go. 16,400 damage, single dash cancel. That's pretty fair, if you ask me. And obviously, could have added a red attack to the beginning of that as well, just to add a little bit extra damage. It would have been 17,000 damage. Like, isn't that just a tiny bit ridiculous, guys? A single dash cancel. And that's off of a regular hit, too. It's not like going off of, like, a unusual hit like some characters can get, you know, if I start with this thing, I can get tons of damage. No. That's his regular attack. You can go into a 16,000 damage combo. It is actually, like, not that difficult, unless you're me and I'm recording. There we go. I just hit again. You can even extend it a bit more with another dash cancel if you want. Or two. or three. To get like 21,000 dash damage for three dash cancels. And that's what I was talking about. There's not really a point in doing his plus ultra one, because he's gonna get ridiculous damage like that anyways. The only like plus time I ever use a plus ultra one or two is if I know they have supports and I just need to get like a single hit into a, like unbreakable damage, because I know they're gonna break my combo instantly. Because, god, against Gran Torino, you need to make sure you always have supports to break a combo, or else you are dead. Because he does so much damage. If your opponent knows how to do combos and they're just not a stupid mashing Gran Torino, like an online Gran Torino, then like 13,000 damage, that's nothing to Gran Torino. If they hit you, you're gonna get in a consistent 16,000 damage combo, so you need to always have your supports ready to break it. So that's why I use the only situation I ever do a plus ultra 1 or 2 is to get damage that they can't break with their supports. Okay, is there really anything else for me to show combo-wise? Actually, yes, there is. Thanks for asking. You can actually get even more damage meterlessly if he has supports. And, like, supports usually aren't even that valuable to Gran Torino. Because you can get tons of damage with, like, no dash cancels or one dash cancel. But if I decide to use an Aizawa support, I'm getting 15,000 damage for zero dash cancel. And I think I could have actually gotten even more if I go... Oh no, wait. Because that'll meet you blow, because he got hit by that last thing. Yeah. Okay, so you're gonna be, like, if you're using it as support, because the all of the hits of this hit, including the last one, which adds to his meaty blow, you're usually only gonna be able to get about 15,000 damage. But why are you complaining about getting 15,000 damage for zero dash cancels? That's ridiculous. And obviously the same can be done with All Might as well, his support, so this team works really well together. If I decide, like, you know, my combos are overpowered, but I don't want to spend, like, I don't want to spend a single dash cancel to get 16,000 damage. That's, oh, so expensive, you know. Yeah, 15,000 damage, and if you didn't realize, I charged up this, so if you want to try and zone me out, I have that move. Or I can just come in with this and I'm safe, and then I get to go into my combos if you try and punish me, so yeah. Guys, I think that's about all I have to say with Gran Torino. He is ridiculous damage, and actually, one last thing I have to show combo-wise is if you've, like, done any kind of combo, I've already kind of shown it, but you can infinitely do this. Like, as long as you have meter, you can infinitely just do a few hits into his quote 2, and as long as you dash cancel, it's not going to add to the meaty blow at all, so you can just do as many of this as you want. Like, that was 3, but you can do, like your entire, take your whole meter out. So basically, if you're against a, when you're playing Gran Torino, if you've done a combo and your opponent has, like, a bit more health than you would, like, usually be able to deal, like, maybe they have 20,000 health, which is, like, 3/4 of their health bar, and you're like, oh man, I can't actually finish them off in my combo, like doing something like this, I messed up, I don't know what I'm doing, but basically, you can just repeat this to the ends of the earth at the end of your combo to add like an extra 10 or 20,000 damage to the end of your combo. And at this point, there's not really much point in doing it anymore, because 25 is the max damage for a combo in this game, but is that not a little bit weird? That's even cheaper. That combo there, oh my god. That combo was cheaper than a plus ultra 3. And it was like the same amount of damage as the Plus Ultra 3. And it was just like based on his regular attacks. And that wasn't optimal at all. You can do it at the end of a combo like this. And here we are, if I ended here, that's actually only cost me 2 plus ultra meters. So it's like the same as a level 2 combo, except it did the same amount of damage as a plus ultra 3 would have with other characters that have a team plus ultra. That is... It's so ridiculous, guys. And a major thing of having a having 16,000 damage as a combo with a single dash cancel is at the beginning of the game, if you get hit by Gran Torino, like when the game starts, you know, when you both don't have your sidekicks and stuff, if you get hit by him, because, you know, he's a really fast attack string in the air, so, you know, it's likely that you'll get hit by it. Like that was... But he can get the 16,000 damage combo before you even have your supports. So you are like have lost over half of your life before you even had the chance. I don't even know what I'm doing anymore. I've gone brain dead and I can't do any of the combos. But he can do 16,000 damage before you have the chance to have your supports and break the combo. Just by using a single dash cancel. So it's not even like Rapa who uses up his like all the meter he has at the start of the game in order to do a combo. This guy can just do a single dash cancel and he's taken over half of your health. Like, what? And then they troll spin. They always troll spin. Anyways, guys, that's Gran Torino. He is like everything overpowered. Overpowered red attack. This amazing like projectile avoiding move. He has amazing like these armored moves that can be used to get into on the opponent or start combos if you want. Like, if someone tries to run up to you while you're doing this, you counter them. You jump into the air, do a full combo. But yeah, he's ridiculous. Obviously he's gonna get nerfed when the first patch come out, but I thought I'd do this now while he's crazy and ridiculous. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!